Most of it is setting up the platform and then creating the content. So, for example, after you set up the platform, which shows you how the LiDAR is really projecting to you and how it's working, you will basically just say, to the people like AMCL, which does a lot of matches LiDAR inputs to the map, and then you would communicate with it and say, DWA plans, these are the parameters that you're using, and based on where your location is, you might have cost. So a lot of our project is setting up the platform and deciding what is best in terms of like decision making, and also like how to intercept like other features, like if someone steals the object to intercept the command system,
right?
There's going to be documentation. And we're looking into also adding other things that will make it more cool. Like if we add successfully managed to connect to the graphic user interface, which we're using actually as a Slack bot, to like just send a text, like, hey, I want coffee, give me coffee right now. And then it'll tell you, you can send the coordinates, and then it would just, like, hopefully it'll be able to handle the request.
So is the NLP being done on the
robot? It's done on the TX2, and the good thing about it is that like the ROS host can even be hosted on the TX2, or it can be actually done on the host machine. So you can actually run ROS for anything and subscribe to it. So that's a good thing. It's flexible. For testing purposes, you probably want to run it on your server host. And then afterwards, you can just move everything on the TX2, and then it's just operating on the TX2.